video, we are going to discuss about imperative programming paradigm. So, imperative programming paradigm is one of the traditional way of programming. So, some programming languages, not some, many programming languages follow imperative programming paradigm style. So, one such is Java. So, we will try to discover the reasons behind that in the later part of this video. So, first, what is the definition of imperative programming paradigm? The word imperative comes from the Latin impero, meaning I command. So, whenever you command something, then that would be called as impero. In case of programming languages, what we are trying to communicate is, we are trying to communicate with the machines by saying that try to add two numbers, try to multiply two numbers, try to divide two numbers, like that. Here, these are the commands. So, this is the first definition. Second definition is, imperative programming is a paradigm of computer programming in which the program describes the sequence of steps that change the state of the computer. So, let us consider a scenario. If you want to add two numbers, you need to communicate that instruction to the system in such a way that machine can understand easily. So our task is to add two numbers. So first, what you will try to do is, you will try to communicate with the machine. So this is your, we can consider this is yourself and this is called system. The first step would be get two numbers from the users. So get two numbers. And the second step would be, second command would be add those two numbers, add two numbers. This is the second command. Third command would be display the output, display the sum, display sum. So these are the three commands. We will try to tell the machine with these three commands. Machine will execute these commands in a better manner. So this is the second step. Imperative programming is a paradigm of computer programming in which the program describes a sequence of steps that changes the state of the computer. And the third point is, it tells the computer how to accomplish this task. This is the important part. Here, we are trying to tell the machine that you try to do this work in this way, so that that would be executed in a better way. So you are trying to guide the machine. That's the important point, how to accomplish a task. And then programs written with this way often compile to binary executable code that runs more efficiently, since all CPU instructions are themselves imperative statements. So we will try to relate this with the real world examples. So for example, if you want to run the CPU fan, then there could be some statements which could be called as imperative statements. If you want to switch on or switch off the machine, then there could be some imperative statements for that. So those statements are written in an efficient manner so that it can save memory and also time. So similarly, if you are trying to write some program, if you follow this imperative programming paradigm style, then that set of statements would be compiled to binary executable code that could run in an efficient manner, both in terms of memory and also time. And then the point is, to make programs simpler to understand, statements have been grouped into sections. So the programming languages that follow imperative programming paradigm style have some blocks in their code. So we will try to explain that. So the programming languages that follow imperative programming paradigm style will support the blocks. For example, if you write some code inside this block, would be treated as this fragment of code. So this code block would have some meaning like that. So this would be very useful for the developers to understand the code in a better manner and also to analyze the and debug the issues. And the last point, which is a very important point, procedural and object-oriented programming languages belong under imperative paradigm. So for example, C, C++, C Sharp, PHP, Java and assembly languages follow imperative programming paradigm style. So I have already said that Java is an object-oriented programming language. Then how could you say that Java is imperative programming paradigm? So you could have this question in your mind. So I will try to explain that. One programming language may follow multiple programming paradigm styles. So here Java follows imperative programming paradigm style, and also it follows object-oriented programming paradigm styles. So this is about imperative programming paradigm.